Yesterday, Kampala State Traders Association petitioned government to intervene in settling a 2 months rental arrears problem after the arcades and shops were closed in March. They suggested that the government use a proportion of the IMF Stabilization Fund to pay landlords on their behalf, or waive the 30% income tax paid by landlords, or even order banks not to ask for interest from loans owed to the landlords. Today, the owners of commercial buildings, shopping malls and arcades, through their chairperson Godfrey Chirumira, welcomed the idea of government intervening in the matter.
We all welcome it, because we are all suffering in the same way.
However, Chirumira emphasized that landlords have several challenges to address, regardless of the lockdown.
The landlords have got their bills, they have got their overheads, they have got loans, they have got URA, taxes to pay, they have got KCC property rates, they have utilities, they have to do renovations. So in that way, they need money.
Speaking for several of the landlords, Chirumira says they are planning to sit with their tenants after the lockdown and reach a common ground.
I'm telling my tenants that we need you and you need us.
The Minister for Trade and Industry, Amelia Chambade, said government is considering this matter.
His Excellency the President has established an economic recovery committee, that will look into some of these challenges that you have been raising. Taxes, Revenue Authority was advised to relax a bit, and I understand it is even offering amnesty. And if you negotiate with them, please negotiate with them, because if you just keep quiet and expect them to look for you, it is also a bit difficult. But make sure you engage them. Let us wait for the committee the President puts in place.
Meanwhile, the Kwagarana Group, which attracts most of the city landlords, have donated a brand new Tata pickup to the COVID-19 task force, while the Madivani Group donated 2 pickups of the same make. The Electoral Commission also chipped in with 15 million shillings. Patrick Senyondo, NTV.